disclaimer for the viewers. I once again welcome you all. In this session, we are going to study the factors affecting transdermal permeation. So let us see the factors affecting transdermal permeation. There are several factors are there which are going to affect the transdermal permeation. These factors are divided into the biological factors, physicochemical factors, formulation related factors, and the environmental factors. Biological factors, for example, which is related with the stratum corneum, regional skin sites, skin condition and disease state, skin age, skin shedding, skin metabolism, blood flow to skin, and the species difference. In the physicochemical factors, for example, skin hydration, then the drug related factors like partition coefficient, then the temperature and pH, drug concentration, diffusion coefficient, molecular size and shape. The formulation related factors like affinity of vehicle for the drug molecules, composition of drug delivery system, then pH of vehicle and the permeation enhancers, and environmental factors like sunlight, cold season and the air pollution. So these are the factors which are going to affect the transdermal permeation of the drug. So let us see the details of the factors which are going to affect the transdermal permeation. Very first one, that is the stratum corneum. So the stratum corneum is the first obstruction to the passage of drug across the skin. See the insect image, which comprises, this is a keratin and an FF, then cornified inner membrane. Then here, it's a lipid bilayer, and here it's a hydrophilic cell content. So again, see the insert. So it's a lipid core, right? And these are the polar heads, sphingolipids, and the fatty acid and the cholesterol. So stratum corneum is the first obstruction to the passage of drug across the skin. It comprises the lipids, and there is a need to alter the lipid in order to increase the permeation of drug through the skin. It gives good permeability to the lipophilic drug. Permeability, it is affected by the rate through which molecule depart from the membrane and penetrate into the epidermis. How the drug it is going to be departed from the stratum corneum and it is going to be further penetrated into the epidermis. We are getting the pause instant in the case of lipophilic drug before appearing it into the systemic circulation, that is due to the steady partitioning kinetics as the drug it is going to be accumulated into the stratum corneum. Lipophilic drug accumulates into the stratum corneum and acts as a depot from which the drug is being released after detachment of patch. So this is about the stratum corneum. Transdermal patches are placed onto the different regions, different locations rather. Say for example, upper chest, upper outer arm, lower abdomen and hip, and there are so many other sites are also there to place the transdermal patch, and depending on that there is a variation in the transdermal permeation. The absorption of a drug from skin depends on nature and characteristic which vary in the different regions. The variation in the cutaneous permeability around the body depends on thickness of skin and nature of stratum corneum and density of the skin appendages. It is not same all over the body. Some of the areas of skin are more permeable, for example, genitalia, particularly the scrotum, axilla, face, scalp, etc. As there is a regional variation in the skin sites, there is a variation in the thickness of skin, variation in the stratum corneum, variation in the density of skin appendages. And as you know that the skin appendages are also responsible for the permeation of drug. The thickness of skin, it also alters the permeability. So regional skin site, it is going to affect the permeability of the drug. So this is about the regional skin sites. Let us move further, and on this slide we are going to discuss the how the skin condition and disease states are going to affect the skin permeability. The intact skin, it is itself, it is going to act as a barrier for the permeability of the drug. Many agents like acids and alkali crosses this barrier cells and penetrates through the skin. Many solvents open the complex dense structure of the corneal layer. For example, the solvents like methanol, chloroform remove the lipid fraction and forming an artificial shunt through which the drug molecule can pass easily. Various skin diseases like psoriasis also results in an alteration of composition of stratum corneum lipid and the protein, and thereby there is an alteration in the permeation of drug. Certainly the injuries which are going to disrupt the continuity of the stratum corneum and increases the permeability due to increased vasodilation. So this is about the skin condition and the disease state. Skin age. Aging results in a huge variation in the vital functioning of the skin. Older subject skin becomes more delicate, sensitive towards peeling and shedding. Applicability of transdermal system to the older patient requires the critical monitoring. Because of the skin, it is sensitive to peeling and the shedding. The young subjects, that is the premature neonates, have poorly developed skin barriers and are more prone towards various percutaneous intoxication resulting from chemical reactions from transdermal patches. So the skin of adults and young ones is more permeable than that of the older one. It indicates that the skin of adult and the young one, it is more permeable than the older one. So in this way, the skin aging affects the permeability of the drug. Let us see the skin shedding. Look at the figure. So here, these are the dead cells which shed from outer surface. Then this is the viable stratum corneum, viable epidermis, dermis. And there is a continuously, the cells are growing and migrating towards the outer surface. So epidermis is in a continuous state of regeneration, and which undergoes various transformations like development of a new cell layer of keratinocytes at the stratum basale and formation of a desiccated proteinaceous corneocytes and eventually the desquamation. This leads to an alteration in the structure of epidermal cells, which changes from stratum basale through the stratum spinosum, stratum granulosum, stratum lucidum to the outermost stratum corneum. So these situations max epidermis as a greatest barrier in the transport of most of the molecules across it. We are considering only the stratum corneum, how it is going to affect the permeability of drug, right? But as epidermal layers are in the continuous regeneration and they're going to be, there is a transformation in the epidermal layer, and drug should permeate through these layers also, right? So in this way, the skin shedding, it is going to affect the permeability of the drug. So epidermis is in a continuous state of regeneration, which undergoes various transformations like development of a new cell layer of keratinocytes at the stratum basale, formation of a desiccated proteinaceous corneocytes, and eventually the desquamation. This leads to alteration in the structure of epidermal cells, which changes from the stratum basale through stratum spinosum, stratum granulosum, and stratum lucidum to the outermost stratum corneum. These situations makes epidermis as a greatest barrier in the transport of most of the molecules across it. And drug could gain the permeability across the full epidermis, and we should not focus only on to the stratum corneum. We should also consider the epidermis. So this is about the skin shedding. Let us move towards the skin metabolism. Epidermis is a biochemically active tissue with a potential for the metabolism. There are many enzymes which are present in the skin, including the cytochrome P450. Epidermis is not capable of enough to metabolize the drug beneath the transdermal patch, and the position of biological degradation is negligible. In fact, the chief merit of the transdermal delivery is that pre-systemic metabolism can be avoided. When we are comparing the skin metabolism with respect to the hepatic metabolism, it is almost less than that of the 10%. Blood flow towards the skin, and increase the blood flow could reduce the amount of time a penetrant remains in the dermis and also raise the concentration gradient across the skin. So by increasing the blood flow towards skin, which increases the permeability of the drug. Then species differences. Mammalian skin differs from species in characters such as a thickness of stratum corneum, number of sweat glands, and a hair follicle per unit surface area. And according to that, the species difference, the permeability is going to be changed. Then lipid film. Lipid film on the skin surface acts as a protective layer to prevent the removal of moisture from the skin and helps in maintaining the barrier function of the stratum corneum. If the lipid film is going to be removed from the skin, thereby it is going to alter the barrier function of skin, and which will promote the removal of moisture from the skin. Skin hydration, it is one of the important factor which is going to affect the permeability of the drug. Hydrated skin generally gives the good permeability to the drug. When water saturates the skin, it swells tissues, softens the wrinkles on the skin, and its permeability increases for the drug molecules that penetrate through the skin. So hydration of skin increases the permeability of drug. So the hydration can be achieved by, there are two ways are there. Very first way, that is it can be achieved by covering the skin with the plastic sheeting, which leads to accumulation of sweat, condensed water vapors, which increases the hydration and furthermore the porosity of skin, and also by use of the humectants, which hydrate the skin and thereby enhances the transdermal permeability. Here also the transdermal drug delivery systems acts as an occlusive moisture barrier through which the sweat cannot pass, and thereby it increases the skin hydration and furthermore the permeation. The next factor is partition coefficient. Drug possessing the both water and lipid solubility absorbed well through the skin. It indicates that drug should have the biphasic solubility, then and then only it is going to be permeated well through the skin. Transdermal permeability coefficient shows a linear dependence on the partition coefficient. As we are increasing the partition coefficient, the transdermal permeability it is going to be increased. Or a solubility of drug in the vehicle may decrease the transdermal permeation of drug. If there is a rise in the solubility of drug in the vehicle, which decreases the transdermal permeability of drug. The optimal partition coefficient, it is ranging between 1 to 4. Drug with a high partition coefficient are not ready to leave the lipid portion of the skin. As already we have seen that the lipid layer from the skin, it is going to act as a depot for the highly lipophilic drug. So the drug, it is going to be accumulated into the skin. And also the drug with a low partition coefficient will not be permeated through the skin. So this is about the partition coefficient. Let us move further. So on this slide, we are going to discuss the temperature of skin and the pH of skin. The temperature of skin, it is going to affect the transdermal permeation. The penetration rate varies if the temperature varies. If there is a change in the temperature, according to that, the penetration rate, it is going to be changed, and diffusion coefficient decreases as temperature falls. So adequate clothing on the body prevents wide fluctuations in the temperature and penetration rate. Rising skin temperature results in an increase in the rate of skin permeation. So rise in skin temperature increases the vasodilation of blood vessels which are in contact with the skin, leading to an increase in the percutaneous absorption. If the temperature is going to be reduced, depending on that, the permeability of drug, it is going to be reduced or it is going to be changed. By rising the skin temperature, which promotes the permeation of drug through the skin. The mechanism involved in the permeation of drug by rising the temperature, which increases the vasodilation of blood vessels which are in contact with the skin and leading to increase in a percutaneous absorption. So it is related with the vasodilation of the blood vessel. That is a temperature effect on the skin, and thereby it increases the permeability of the drug. Let us see the pH of skin. Only unionized molecule pass readily across the lipid membrane, and weak acids and bases dissociate to different degrees according to their pH, pK or pKb. So already all of you are aware about the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation. So we have to suppose to consider this specific equation. Thus, the concentration of unionized drug in a applied phase will determine the effective membrane gradient, which is directly related to its pH. Only unionized drug can permeate easily than the ionized form. And ionization of the drug, it is being decided by the vehicle which is used in the formulation, that is vehicle pH. Then it is decided by the pH of the skin and the pK of the drug molecule. So this is about the pH. Drug concentration. Transdermal permeability is a passive diffusion process. higher the concentration of drug in the vehicle, there is a faster absorption. Already we have seen the kinetics of transdermal permeation by using the flux equation. So the transdermal permeability, it is a passive diffusion process, and higher the concentration of drug in the vehicle, there is a faster the absorption. Higher concentrations than solubility, the excess solid drug will function as a reservoir in the formulation and helps to maintain a constant drug constitution for prolonged period of time. The amount of drug percutaneously absorbed per unit of surface area per time interval increases with an increase in the concentration of drug in the transdermal drug delivery system. So the drug concentration in the formulation, it is going to affect the transdermal permeability. So transdermal permeability is a passive diffusion process. If the formulation contains higher amount of the drug, that will facilitate the drug absorption. At higher concentrations than the solubility, the excess solid drug will function as a reservoir and which helps to maintain a constant drug constitution for the prolonged period of time. The amount of drug percutaneously absorbed per unit of the surface area per time interval increases with an increase in the concentration of drug in the TDDS. So this is about the drug concentration, how it is going to affect the transdermal permeability. Let us see the molecular size and shape. Molecular size and shape, it is going to affect the transdermal permeability. Generally, the drugs which are having molecular weight less than 400 Dalton can cross easily the skin barrier, and the particle size, it should be small. So smaller particle size have more permeability than the larger particle. So the release of a drug from a dosage form is less due to the dead nature of the stratum corneum. As already we have discussed the anatomical part of the skin, and now we are aware about the stratum corneum, it is going to affect the skin permeability. And certainly we have to suppose to use the certain technologies which can enhance the permeability of drug by changing the physicochemical or physiological things related with the stratum corneum, and furthermore which will increase the penetration of drug through the skin. So certainly the certain physical technologies or physical methods, like say for example sonophoresis, or the chemical permeation enhancers like DMSO, which increases the transdermal permeability of the drug. Let us move towards the pH of vehicle. The acidic or alkaline pH may cause the irritation. So whatever the pH we have selected for the formulation, it should be near to the skin pH. And furthermore, the vehicle pH, it is going to affect the drug release, degree of hydration of polymer, and therefore the surface pH of patches should be determined to optimize both drug as well as the adhesion. And this pH, that is vehicle pH, is also going to affect the adhesion. So this is about the pH of vehicle. pH of vehicle for the drug molecule can influence the release of a drug molecules from the vehicle. If the drug is having a highest affinity towards the vehicle, such drugs are going to be resided into the formulation. The solubility of vehicle will determine the release rate of the drug. The mechanism of drug release depend on whether the drug is in a dissolved state or suspended in the drug delivery system, and on the interfacial partition coefficient of the drug from the delivery system to the skin tissue. The composition of drug delivery system, it is not only affect the rate of drug release, but also the permeability of stratum corneum by means of hydration mixing with a skin lipids. So composition of drug delivery system, it not only affects the rate of drug release, but also the permeability of stratum corneum by means of hydration mixing with a skin lipid. So which types of the excipients which are using in the formulation, that is very important one. For example, methyl salicylate is more lipophilic than its parent acid, that is a salicylic acid. So when applied to skin from fatty acid vehicle, methyl salicylate yielded a higher absorption. So the composition of drug delivery system, it is also important factor and which will decide the transdermal permeation. Let us see the sunlight, environmental factors. Because of sunlight, the walls of blood vessel becomes a thinner. You may be aware about the sunburns and other related effects leading to the bruising with only minor trauma in the sun exposed areas. Also, there is a pigmentation. The most noticeable sun induced pigment change is the freckle or the solar lentigo. Sunlight changes the skin properties and thereby there is a change in the permeability of the drug. In the cold season often results in a itchy and dry skin. The skin responds by increasing oil production to compensate for the weather's drying effect. If the skin is going to dry, definitely the drug permeability, it is going to be altered. A good moisturizer will help to ease symptoms of dry skin. Also, drinking lots of water can keep your skin hydrated and looking radiant. So hydration of skin, it is very important in the cold season. If the skin becomes dry, the permeability of drug, it is going to be changed. Herewith, we have finished the factors affecting transdermal permeation. We have discussed the biological factors, then physicochemical factors, formulation related factors, and the environmental factors. Before design and development of the transdermal drug delivery system, there is a need to understand all these factors so as to it is possible to get the optimal transdermal drug delivery system.